Hello and welcome to This and That Thursday. I'm your host Heather and we are going to be working with the three colors from the February Three Colors Challenge here at the Craft Shack. I'm not going to be using DecoArt paints today though. I thought that I would pull things out of my stash that might be close to those colors, and close is really all they are. So I've got these Ranger acrylic paints. Yeah, so here's the thing. I've been forcing myself since the beginning of the year to, to use products that I have had. You know how it is when you go to the store and you're like, oh my gosh, I have to have this brand new, just saw a video on it, whatever it might be. Hey, maybe you even saw a video at the Craft Shack and you just had to buy it, and then it sits and you never use it. Well, that's kind of how these paints have been for me. These are distress paints from the Tim Holtz line of products by Ranger. That's the word I was looking for. And I love these paints because of how they work together. Like, you know, they'll kind of sort of mingle. They don't really blend the way regular paints do. And as long as they're wet, they still react the same way that distress paint reacts or distress inks react. But yeah, so it'd been a while since I've used these, so I was kind of like timid. I didn't really even know what the heck I was going to do. So I have myself a 6x6 canvas panel, and I pulled out these colors because they went in line with the monthly colors. And although this particular coral is a much brighter coral color than the three color challenges, but so I just sort of dabbed some on, and then I got it wet, and then I tried to move it around, and then as it was drying, I was like, oh yeah, these are reactive with water. So before I dried it completely, I reacted it with water. Yeah, it's like I didn't really know what I was doing, to be honest with you. Sometimes you just got to get your products out and play with them. Like, it's almost like reintroducing yourself to an old cousin or something that you haven't seen since last Christmas. Or maybe three Christmases ago, or since your great great aunt's funeral. That's what it feels like. Anyway, so I wasn't quite sure what I was going to do, but I decided that I had these sheet music pieces from previous projects, and I thought, okay, well, let's do this textury thing that I've been doing lately and pick up some of that paint with those. And while that's drying, I'm thinking a lot and adding more paint to the paper. And I'm thinking, I totally spaced out that these paints like intermingle with each other, and I just sort of dried it off. And then I was like, now what am I going to do? Well, I wanted to introduce that other color, but I didn't want to make mud either, so I'm sort of fiddling around with them at this point. And here's where you'll see the difference in the greens. In the three color challenge, it was Sea Breeze by Americana. And then this one, I don't remember what the name of this color is. You know, I should probably have those in front of me, but I don't. But it's just a little bit lighter. So whereas the coral was much brighter than the three color challenge, I think the reason why I'm showing you all this is because I'm not that picky. I don't think that we should have to be like, hey, that's not even close to the right color. All it's supposed to do is inspire you. So hopefully you're getting inspired by these three color challenges. We do it every month. You have all month long to play along. So, all right. So I decided that I'm going to color the other papers with the other color. And I like that you could see the paper underneath still and the blotchy paint on there. I really like that, but I still have no purpose, no direction, no clue as to what I'm going to do. So let's just add more paint to more paper. Again, this is all scrap paper from another project done earlier this month. And that's when I decided that I would add this color to the canvas as well. But I didn't really have any idea of how I wanted to do it or what. And the adding water to it, I thought would help it move, and it really didn't very much. So now I use my finger. Yeah, again, so I really don't have any clue of what I want to do with this. All I know is that by the time I get to the end, I'm happy with it. So this was really about experimenting with products I haven't seen in a while, having lunch with an old friend. That's what it was seemed like to me. And just playing around, trying to get something artistic done. And in the end, I'm really happy with it. And as a matter of fact, I used this piece as the second art piece for patrons. So if you are a patron, then and you are at a level where you receive the second art piece of the month in a print form of some kind, then you've got a print coming in the mail or have already received it by now. So this is fun. I pulled out this stamp that I have not, this was all about using stuff I've not seen in a while or haven't ever used. In this case, I've never used this stamp and I don't even know how to get it out. And I'm fiddling with the box and I left this part in because I figured you might also fiddle with your packaging and might want to feel a little bit better about it. And it turns out it just slides right out. Like there's no box to open. It was so simple. Anyway. So I'm going to use some archival ink because I don't know if I'm done with this canvas. Like, I honestly do not have a clue where I'm going with any of it. I just know I wanted to put that pretty text somewhere. And so while I was inking it up, I was thinking, do I want to just do little bits and pieces of text, or do I want to try and put the whole image as a focal point, or why did I put color on those music papers again? Like, I really don't know where I'm going with any of this. This is just me trying to use things that are in the Craft Shack that I may or may not have ever touched before. And when I put it down, I didn't center it, and that kind of sort of, as I was inking it, going, okay, so it's going to be a background image. Good idea. And so, to really make it a background image, we should probably put more on. Yeah. All right, so as you're watching me stamp this, I gotta explain. Sometimes I just do art for me. And sometimes I have an agenda. Most of the time, I have an agenda because, well, I have patrons that I need to create art for. I have a YouTube channel that I have to produce videos for, and I'm trying really hard to get this show on the road so that way I can bring classes to you where you live. And in order to do all of that, I've got to work really hard getting videos out and blog posts, etc., etc. And of course, I do sell my art and prints of my artwork, so in order to get any of that done, you have to make more stuff, right? But all the time that I'm doing those things, I think to myself, it'd be really nice to just do something for the fun of it. And that's what this was. I just happened to record it because I was doing something before this that I have been asked to show in video. And so I had recorded that and then kept the camera rolling and didn't realize it until I was going through that footage. And here it is. And I'm like, huh. Well, that was convenient. So now I pick up the pieces of paper and I think to myself, what are we going to do with these? All of these. All right, let's just tear them up. And as I'm tearing them up, I'm getting an idea. So I'm not going to make you sit through all of that. We're going to speed this up. But I've got an idea. These ones are just green in that first pile, and the ones in the middle have mostly green, but some of that corally color. And then the ones at the top are mostly coral with some of the green on them. And I did that on purpose because I think what I've decided to do is I'm going to use this month's theme of hearts. And I think we're going to put some torn pieces of hearts. And right about now, I realize, you know what? You need a heart shape on there to follow. So now, this is again another funny moment that I just had to keep in here because I'm sure this happens to you. I'm using a pencil and I'm drawing out this heart. And I didn't use any guideline, I'm just drawing a shape. And the right side is a little skinny and the left side is a little large. but I didn't really notice it at first. And then when I got to this part, I realized you can't really see it. Not only can you not see it on the camera, but I was really struggling to see it too. And I decided to erase it, and I thought, that's not going to work. Okay, don't worry about that. Get some white charcoal. That'll help. No, not really. See what I mean? You can't really see it all that well. Is it going to be okay? No. Let's try an oil pastel. Another item that I have never really used much of. And so I decided that was going to be a part of today's project. But because I rarely, if ever, use oil pastels, I have not even touched them yet. And so I thought, okay, well, I'll use them to outline. And at least the camera can see it a little bit better. All right, so what I want to do is focus on those torn edges and sort of have them go around the whole heart, both hearts, that the torn edge is the outside edge of the whole thing. And I'm just using some DecoArt matte medium to glue them down. And these are very old pieces of paper. These music sheets are incredibly old, and so they're very brittle and they're kind of thick. So they were really difficult to glue down in the sense that it wasn't thin tissue paper. And you see me fiddle with that quite a bit, but I am going to speed up the gluing process so you don't have to sit through that whole mess. All in all, this entire piece from start to finish took me about 1 hour and 20 minutes. So I did cut it down to a more manageable piece for you, but there was a lot of dead space also where I didn't, because I wasn't intending to record. It was just more a matter of playing with art supplies for myself. And because of that, there was a lot of time where I wasn't actually arting, but the camera was on. So, anyway. So you'll see me glue them all down here. And I just tried to stay sort of within that line that I drew or the multiple lines I drew. And it's funny because I zoom in here, like I must have known that the camera was on, but I wasn't making this for any special reason. I just ended up liking it so much I had to share it with the patrons. But I didn't set off to make this a certain anything or for any one reason. Now, on the second heart, I decided that I really wanted to use some of those contrasting colors, which goes back to why I made those three piles so that I knew which pile to use and not get confused, not confuse myself a little bit there, so that as I'm building this with those contrasting pages, one will stand out from the other. So I knew I wanted that larger one to be more green because of how corally the background is, and I wanted that one in front to be more orange because of how green that larger heart is. But once this was totally dry, which I did blow dry that and realized I didn't really like how intense the background was. So I took some titanium buff, DecoArt fluid acrylic, and some water, and I started painting the background. Now, before you panic, because I know some of you out there are having a canary right now because I'm covering up that amazing background we spent all that time making. I actually will dab quite a bit of that off. It's just I'm trying to make it push back behind the hearts. And so I've grabbed some paper towel and I'm going to dab it off. And yeah, I think that's going to work. So we're going to try it on the whole thing and see what it looks like. Now, I had focused on using Tim Holtz distress paints because I can't even remember the last time I pulled any of those out. I focused on using a stamp that I had never even taken out of the package because I don't know why. I just never did. So I'm glad that I finally pulled that out because that's been hiding in my stash. And then I'm going to pull out the oil pastels, which I don't know, to be honest with you, I've ever used for any project on camera, but I had to have them. Now, I did buy a very inexpensive set from Michael's. I think it was $5 for like 500 million oil pastels. Okay, that might be a slight exaggeration. Maybe it's only 500,000. But anyway, it is a huge big box of oil pastels for like $5. So you know they're not going to be of like incredibly high quality and the best thing that you could ever buy. But obviously, I didn't need to have the best since I rarely ever use them. But I thought it might be a good idea to pull them out because I don't use them, and I see people use them in their mixed media all the time, and I think, don't I have some of those? Why don't I use those? So this was the challenge for me, and it's been the challenge since the beginning of the year, is to try and find things in the craft room that I don't use very often and figure out why. Either I don't use them because I don't know how, or I don't use them because I've found an alternative that I'd prefer over them. But then why do I still have them? Or I just might not have come up with the right project for them yet. And whatever the case may be, I really felt like it was time to fix that. And so that's been the goal for 2017. I think because of the downsizing that we're going to need to do real soon, I'm kind of worried I might not ever get to play with some of these things. So I'm forcing myself to utilize them. And I'm hoping that you will get some benefits to that by seeing some things you rarely see around here. All right, so I'm being really particular about around the heart combination there because I really wanted the two hearts to stand out more. And I've just decided at some point, I think I'm drawing this now, at some point I'm like, this isn't working quite how I wanted it to. So, I'm pretty sure I'm going to grab some oil pastels and work with those. I think. Coming up soon. Unsure why I didn't speed up the drying process, but whatever. Okay, yes. So now I've got the oil pastels, and although I have 500,000 of them in a box that I got for $5, I do not have the right colors for this particular challenge. So I'm kind of making my own. I took that pink that was as close to the pink in the challenge, and then this sort of fleshy color, and sort of mixing them together. And it's sort of a coral blush-ish color, sort of. But see, that didn't really help it stand out either. All right, so same goes with the greens. I've got this dark green, obviously not the right green. And then this super, super light green that sort of calms it down and makes it a little bit closer to the sea breeze color we're after. Sorta. And I was blending them with my finger, and that was kind of okay-ish. But remember, these are really, really inexpensive. And I got the baby wipe out thinking that would help, and it doesn't. These are oil pastels, not water-soluble oil pastels. Okay, so now what? Let's just keep adding lots more of the two colors. So while I'm trying to figure out the best way to do this, I'm also thinking about like the shading aspect of it, and I get a little confused there where I wanted to put some on one side of the heart and some on the other side of the heart, and I just decided it's kind of like a half and half deal. That's what I ended up going with. I do know now why I don't use these very often, these oil pastels, because wax is not, or oil, any of that is not my cup of tea. I just don't like the mess that it puts on my finger, as well as I don't want to give you any spoilers, but I am going to do something that will remind me why I don't use these very soon. We'll get to it. hearts. And I'm just using the baby wipe to sort of clean off the hearts themselves because I really want them to be more of a focal point. And they still seem to be very, although they stand out a little better than they did, they still seem to be very blended into the background. So I'm kind of disappointed with that, so I'm just going to move on. I have this stamp, another stamp set I've owned for a long time, and I've never used this stamp at all. And I stamped it onto some tissue paper, and I'm using the matte gel to glue it down. And I'm going to go over the top of it as well, and it's sort of that tissue paper just sort of blends into the background, so works out quite well. That's my new favorite thing to do, stamp on tissue paper instead of on my project. It's perfect. Okay, so I'm going to get out the heat tool, and here's where it all goes a little wrong because, and let my mistake be a lesson to you, when you use the heat tool on oil pastels, it will melt. Now, you probably already knew that, but this was a learning lesson for me. So I'm sharing my wisdom, my newfound wisdom. And at some point, I mean, it's happening. Oh, I'm noticing. Tilt it back and forth real quick, and I see something shiny. Let's pause for a second and just take a look. It's melting, Heather. It's melting. Okay, well, what are you going to do about that? Might as well make it all melt. It actually kind of softened it up a little bit as it melted, so I kind of got excited about that. So excited, I went and stuck my finger in the hot oil and realized that hurt. Wiped that off. But see, I'm really lucky because this finger that I'm using right now, it's what I call my dead finger. I have no feeling in it at all. I chopped the tip of it off a long time ago with the mandolin, but that's for another story. Anyway, I'm using that to sort of deal with that melted oil pastel, and it blended out quite nicely. But this is one of those moments where I was like, now what? Yeah, I'm not too sure. Why don't we get a black Inktense pencil and see if we can add some black to the hearts? That might help with the shadowing. But I was a little concerned because I thought, is the oil pastel going to get in the way? And so that's why I was kind of inspecting a little bit. So I decided to go to the inside of where the oil pastel is onto the paper heart there. And that's what I focused on, both hearts. And then I'm going to get myself a brush and dip it in some water. Now remember, the Inktense pencils, they're water soluble. They react with water, but then once they're dry, they're permanent, which is a reason why I like the Inktense pencils. Oh, and this is hilarious. I'm actually getting my brush wet by spraying water on a paper towel. It wasn't a smart day. But anyway, okay, so I'm just getting it wet and sort of giving it a soft finish. The oil pastel is sort of balling up there a little bit. It's very, very weird. I'm realizing I don't really like using those for this project. But I'm proud of myself because I have pulled out things that I don't normally use, and I think I'm making them work. Yeah, what do I want to do here? Yeah, see, there's lots of thinking going on. I will tell you that the last probably 10 minutes of this project are not on screen, and the reason for that is because, like I said at the very beginning, I really turned the camera on by accident for this project and did not intend for it to ever be seen. So I got out my painter's pen. I have filled this pen with fluid ink, and it works great for doing edges like this. I love this thing. But when you see there that blob there, I'm about to clean up there. That actually happened when I took the cap off, so didn't even realize it until then. But anyway, so I'm putting this black paint edge around the whole thing. And what you won't see me do is I do add some more black Stabilo All pencil to the hearts, and I do use the third color, Dazzling Metallics Shimmering Silver, as some highlights into the L, O, V, and E. I add some like little gem shapes in there. But you'll see that at the very end in a still photo. And again, this image is, I made prints of it for the patrons so that they could actually have this as an ATC or a 5x7. And the original belongs to one of my $50 patrons, so it was a great pleasure to actually mail it off to her, and hopefully she enjoys it. But there you can see I did add some more black to those hearts, and I put silver on the letters. So I hope that you've enjoyed watching, and that you will give it a thumbs up if you did. And if you didn't, if you'd let me know why, so that I can improve. I really do appreciate you watching this and that Thursday at the Craft Shack. Have a crafty day.